Satterfield in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Camp Fire One. Nobody's going to enjoy any Camp Fire marshmallows just yet.
I ate 3 packages of them yesterday.
Yeah, wait a second.
I did. I felt a little lightheaded. I thought, you know what I mean? It's a healthy snack. I'm going to smash 3 bags of marshmallows.
Did you enjoy them with some chocolate mustard?
I did. I dipped them in there.
It's great, but I tell you, man, Camp Fire marshmallows are clearly doing something for Satterfield and Bob Carter. That's a team that's really struggled the last few years. Now they're out here with a 580 hot rod. We just talked about how you really need to be there. We're going in the 70s to kind of make a splash out here. They are trending the right direction, and you can literally see it in their eyes and their smiles. They're over the moon down there. Those guys are having the time of their life, having a car that's capable of getting to the show.
Well, it really started at Mike Biehle, of course, staging up on the Bud side of the racetrack. Biehle is running 82 and 78, so he's got some consistency going on as well. Biehle typically makes the show, though, and so Hunt Satterfield was experienced the change in the direction of his luck.
Let's face it, a couple of races ago, for the past 2 years, they've been just battling every problem, and they had a lucky race. They eliminated first round, reinserted into the field, able to go through the rounds, made the final round, just the racing gods smiling upon them, and it's weird, from that moment, they've kind of trended in the right direction. Now, finding the performance, trying to make the show right.
Starting line.
Unbelievable, man. The rear wheel's completely locked up on that thing. It spun it all the way around. I don't know if that was a brake-induced lockup or if it was some sort of driveline.